Hello, this is Jason with Maya. Today we're going to take a look at pattern along curve in Solid Edge 2022. It's one of my favorite patterning commands, actually. It's so powerful. Here we have an example of its use, and this is typically what you would think of with pattern along curve, something like this, a very curvy shape. The command is here, of course. Let's take a look at how it was created. There's two patterns for the inners and the outers. So we have an inner chain link and an outer chain link. That's all that we have going on here. They are assembled onto this curve element. So let's examine what we have. We have the components selected. We then select the curve. And the start point is all set. And then it's a simple matter of, in this case, using follow curve chord, because the distance between the pins is always, you know, a fixed distance. We need the distance in a straight line between the two points. So that's required for this type of calculation. And then the curve position tells it to rotate as it translates to each point. It uses the curve to determine its rotational amount for each chain. And of course, you could change the reference point. Don't see a use for that here. You can suppress occurrences by simply clicking on a dot after clicking this button, and you can insert occurrences manually. I'll show you that in a second with a different part. So quite easy to use, but sometimes people won't think to use pattern along curve for some more simpler applications. So if we choose pattern along curve and select our components and the patterns and accept, and I've drawn a little sketch here, this could be the edge of a component, or it could be a sketch that you drew, but we probably want only two there. And so we've kind of replicated that chain very easily. And it's going to be driven by that sketch for the spacing. Just a cool, really simple application. You could certainly use a rectangular pattern as well. Let's take a look at another assembly. This actually came up in the community as a question. The user wanted to pattern this caster, but he wanted the wheels to be facing all in the same direction. So if you do a circular pattern, they'll each get rotated. So pattern along curve was a pretty good solution here. We select the component, or in this case, sub-assembly, and then I'll just use the edge of the model. You could certainly use a sketch. Now I want the start point to be here, so I'll use this awesome project point to curve. So it's going to take this center point, it's going to project it there, just so that the pattern is done the way that I want. You would see the difference if you tried it both ways. And then I'll just accept, and I'll use four so it becomes obvious. But you do notice the wheels are going in a kind of a rotational, so you'll just be spinning in circles all day. But here we have a very simple option that you can use. And by simple, it seems to mean that it's turned off any rotations here, and it's just simply making a copy to each instance marker of that edge. So I deliberately put this plate off center so that would become obvious. So another win for pattern along curve. Yet another example here. I've created a simple cylinder, drew a sketch, wrapped it down so I have a curve that is of the length of that rectangle, just as something fun to do. And we'll use pattern along curve again. A little FYI, you can just pattern an edge, and sometimes that can be useful if you don't want to cut all those holes in that cylinder. That can get expensive. If you have thousands of holes, you can just pattern an edge. And it will show up on the drawing. If you turn that setting on in drafting, you can get that to look perfect in drafting, and that may be all you need to manufacture that part without all the expensive overhead of modeling those holes. So we're just going to use that curve that origin. The offset would be from the start point. I like it. I want it to start right at the beginning. And we'll give it a count of 20. And move on to the next step. So often step two is overlooked. It actually is a, so they describe it pretty well in the tooltip. It's a repeat. So it takes the initial pattern and then repeats it along a different curve. And this is really a cool application for it. It's a little bit like a rectangular where you have columns and rows, except it's actually rotating in one direction and translating in the other. So I'm gonna go ahead and just choose the other leg, and it's the same process. And probably don't need as many. So there you go, pattern along curve using two directions. So the last option I called uneven pattern. This happens to be a synchronous part. I like to do a little bit of work in synchronous because it is such cool technology. Remember, synchronous, it's all about the selection. So I'm going to select my entire cutout first and then grab my pattern along curve. The workflow is a little bit different, but the math that happens is essentially the same. We're going to select a couple of elements and accept. It's asking me for the origin, and I just click, and the quantity will just do 2, because what I really want to show you is this great capability to insert manually at a vertex. In this case, it would be the endpoint of a line, but you can also pick up, if I right click to apply that one, you can even add one to the midpoint of a vertex as well. And what is really amazing is that this is it's associative to the sketch. So the pattern instances, so it's a replication of the original cutout, but it's all driven by this sketch. And if we wanted to take that a little bit further and do another one, we'll do, this is nothing more than a sketch where I unlocked the plane and drew a sketch on each side of the block. So it's very similar to what I've been doing. I need to click the origin, point the little arrow. Again, I only want 2, one for the start and one for the end. If you didn't want the one at the end, you can just simply suppress it. So, but now I'm going to go here and choose follow using plane, and we pick the top plane and accept. So I'll get one at the end, one at the start. But here I can go and insert one manually on the other side. And these will all adjust when we adjust the sketch. So very cool capability, pattern along curve. And because you stuck with me all the way to the end, I'll show you this oddly satisfying animation of the chain. So thanks for watching today.